Welcome to Adecco TV. I'm Ann Meyer. You're joining us from SHRM's 2011 annual conference and exposition in Las Vegas, Nevada. Here, we're bringing you the latest trends and innovative solutions from some of the country's leading experts in the HR industry. Joining me now is Valerie Grubb, principal of Val Grubb & Associates.
Thanks so much for being with us.
Thanks, Ann. I'm delighted to be here.
Well, let's talk a little bit. Address for us how, under the Obama administration, the U.S. is asserting a leadership role in green initiatives throughout the world and what the impact is on companies.
It's really the U.S. reaching out to China, to India, these other emerging countries, to help them kind of learn from us. Like, we've been in the business of creating a mega powerhouse for 100 years, and we're kind of helping them to step up and get up to looking at clean emissions and all it kind of not sort of not pollute what we did for the last 100 years. We've had, you know, the green stimulus programs are putting 17 jobs for every $1 million into the economy. So a lot of opportunities with this whole new emerging technology that the U.S. is taking the lead in. SHRM actually did a survey last year. 55% of employees said that having a sustainability and a green program helps the company improve its morale. Those are big, big numbers. They also found at the end of the year, they did another survey and found that 73% of the workforce felt that green initiatives were one of the most important initiatives that their company needed to look at. It's just such an opportunity as an HR representative and as an HR executive to step in and lead your company's initiatives on them.
How can going green really improve employee retention, workforce training, and leadership development programs?
There's just so many things that you can look at when it comes to going green. There are your sort of your low-hanging fruit, if you will, of paper recycling and e-cycling and all of this. And then you can get into larger initiatives that touch across departments. And that's why I think that HR is so uniquely qualified to do this, because they're used to going across departments. And so you can really, when it comes to sort of the birth to the death of your product, you can help spearhead and really kind of capture the employee's imagination and sort of like prod them to see if there's a way that you can do it more greenly with packaging, with distribution, with how we ship it, with the products that you make it out of.
Tell us what the top three low to no cost green initiatives that companies can really immediately adopt.
I would certainly say, you know, there's a huge paper pandemic. 31% of waste is generated through paper. So even something as small as double-sided printing, of using, reusing paper, switching to energy-efficient light bulbs. I would certainly say another one is e-cycling. E-cycling is one of the largest problems going on in the United States today because of all of this emerging technology. You know, iPad 2 just came out. So you got to get rid of your old iPad. All of that stuff has bad things in it. Bad things for the air, bad things for the environment. So certainly look into e-cycling, I would strongly suggest.
Thank you so much, Valerie. Of course, to get more information about SHRM 2011 and to keep your finger on the pulse of cutting-edge trends and insights from the human resource industry, visit us at clearingthepicture.com or adeccousa.com. Thanks for joining us at Adecco TV.